Oh, it's a code thing. Maybe it's like Da Vinci Code.
Yeah. Hi. Really?
Welcome back to Overused Anonymous. Today I was not allowed to eat.
It said it right next to the front door, didn't it?
Yeah.
Wait. So, do you know the way Fitz prides himself on being
the head of logistics?
Yeah. You've really dropped the ball on this one.
He has dropped the ball on this one.
Probably because he's dropping too much alcohol.
Oh, do you know what that is?
Science.
What was that?
Ro-Raggy.
Ro-Raggy.
Don't say the R word on camera, please.
Rape.
Jesus Christ.
Oh, you have to edit it now. So my name is Keenan Cornelius, and tomorrow I'm fighting in the blue belt division.
Rambo, can you say Ezekiel Choke?
Oh my god, where?
Ezekiel Choke.
We are one of the...
No, there's no
me
in this.
Who's
me? There's no
me. You're the only person.
You were not reading the instructions I sent to you.
Disclaimer, you took the phone off of me.
You did?
Because
he actually said, why don't I do that? And took, literally, with his ego hands. And then he knocked me in the face.
You did just grab it from him and then let him check, like.
Because he's a child.
What's it saying in the thing?
Because he's a useless child.
What's it saying in the thing?
3 years old.
Remember, you.
Yeah, of course, Griffey.
Thanks, Pat. And that's how Rambo tore a bicep.
Friend walks. So gifted, naturally talented, genetic freak of nature.
And we've got Rambo.
And then behind Fitz.
Hey!
It's a me.
No, we're not in Rome anymore.
I said this 10 minutes ago. It's the locked box is next to the door.
Well, not worry. Remember, do you remember that?
It's actually on camera, so I have that. I will have that.
It's on camera.
I can't let you get
close. Oh, wanna know? Wanna know?
Please stop. I can't let you get close.
Can you hear my?
Do you see how belligerent he gets?
He's very angry, isn't he?
I think he should get his hormones checked.
I think he's taking estrogen at the time. His tits are getting massive. Yay!
Hey, shh, there's other people in here.
Fuck them.
Shh.
Fuck them.
You can't fuck them, you don't even know her. Fuck her. I don't even know her. Oh, who fucked this?
Oh, girl.
I'm sleeping in the bathroom.
Our two singles are so close together.
And the two became one.
Unison.
All right, who's got the coke? Rambo, give us a status update.
Currently, about 0.6 of a kg overweight. hoping to really shred down here in the last moments of my comp.
We got a mirror, let's go to the mirror.
Oh, we got two mirrors. So this is Pinky in the Brain.
Yes.
I am, we're actually Pinky in the toe now, because I'm after injuring my toe.
Yeah.
So, Gurf still has his
other side.
Has his splint.
Yep. Basically fully healed up.
On advice of council,
we decided to
wing it.
Yeah.
Because we might be looking at an all Sika final.
If only. So currently Dara has a boy.
So
Dara has a boy.
Will we give him the full backstory?
Give him the full backstory.
So our coach, Galera, Phenomenal jiu-jitsu player.
Yeah. One of the best.
Backed Dara.
Yeah.
And I said from day one, no, Gurf is naturally faster. And he's timid. You were very timid at the start, not to get hurt. But you came out as a monster, like.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So I backed Gurf. Mm-hmm. And then you registered for the competition. Mm-hmm. Gurf had no one in his weight division.
Yeah.
So what he did was he registered in Dara's weight division, which was like above 105, because Dara's cutting to 120 at the moment. So Gurf is weighing in at...
but 102, 103.
102, yeah. And Dara's just down to... I think he got to 119 today.
Yeah, I think...
Before the flights and the airplane food, yeah, and stuff like that. Like, so I'd say he'd be like 121 for the comp.
What did he eat? Like, was it three pizzas by himself, I think?
Yeah, we went to Domino's. I wasn't allowed to eat.
Yeah.
Because I'm severely overweight. And there was six pizzas ordered for five people, and two of them were kids.
Yeah, and Dara
and
is.
We never saw three of them.
Just don't know where they went.
Dara got a mixed. He just went up and said, give me three random pizzas.
Look how skinny I am.
You're looking so slim.
So babe. Slim.
So slim.
Yeah, it's great, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm digging. You're definitely better shape.
This t-shirt's no good for me as well, like.
No, you're looking great. So the standing as it is there's...
Yeah.
Dara
has a bye into the final. Three into the semi-finals. Yeah.
I have three fights to gold, and Dara has two fights because he got a bye.
See, he's definitely on estrogen tablets because he's got going up.
That's the closest I've ever seen you to having abs ever.
You're actually looking very good, Dara.
No, this is the best I've seen you look.
You look very good. Give us a tens.
The two of you are annoying the shit out of me.
Why?
Just because I can hear you talking about the cutting to 120. Like, we said that was going to be a...
confidential yoke.
What?
Confidential, like.
Yeah, like, I thought we wouldn't tell people.
Does it bother you how low his nipples are?
It concerns me how long his torso is, but when we sit down, we're the same height, so I'm not sure what's going on.
Not too worried, like.
I don't know what's going on, like.
So, do you want my predictions for tomorrow?
Go on.
I think we are looking at a SEEK final. I'm not going to give my predictions on the final of who will win.
I fucking hope to God I'm in the final, because I already got a buy into the semi.
Yeah, to go back to our original story, our head coach is in with the coordinator of the competition, and he made a phone call and said, listen, my fighter needs a buy into the semi. So Dara's actually walking away with a third place medal no matter what.
Yeah.
So he has two fights to win, same as myself.
Yeah, same as yourself.
I got a buy into the semis as well, because they wanted to give
because
Galera is also my coach. No, basically they were like, look, this guy's really fucked.
Jesus. If you could smell the shit.
That's
fucking sewage.
It's very bad.
You want to close that? Open the window, I'll deserve.
I can't let you get close. I can't let you get close.
I wonder if this will get taken down because Dejan Wick.
We've already
So we're back to part two of S&C Reacts. Coaches with the resident jiu-jitsu expert.
Oh, and the expert, yeah.
Ian Campbell to Rambo.
Ian Rambo Campbell.
Ian Corno.
So we've got John coming into a scene here. This isn't the scene, it's not the jiu-jitsu scene.
Please check back in later.
All right, we'll be back in 10 minutes.
Cut.
You don't fucking want the shotgun in that mode. Do you want the shotgun?
Have a large
look. Not
look
that
at
fucking
this. Nice. Reloads it and pumps him in the chest.
Pause this.
Pause.
Where's the remote? He had a fucking shell in a shell holder next to the chamber. And he fucking pulled it out of his pocket to put it in.
Yeah.
Don't fucking yell at me.
Oh, how far back are you going? Fuck's sake.
Okay.
What?
So sick of what?
I can't say anything.
Okay, look there.
Yeah.
Barrel's too long, because it's the wrong
gun.
That's
what happened with Neymar.
No, because barrel's shorter, and you've much better control over Neymar. Look. Shell. What's this? In a shell holder next to the chamber?
Another fucking shell. What's he grab?
He grabs a shell out of his pocket.
Yeah.
And puts it in.
Style of points.
He's a very. No.
Do you wear style points?
No.
Do you wear style points, no?
No. Do you know why that is? Because an armorer put that shell over on the side of his shotgun.
Yeah.
Not him.
This is phenomenal. Choreography is good. There are some errors in Spider Gears.
There's massive errors with the fact that your man missed him four times, supposedly.
Right, watch this now.
Okay.
Just general arresting.
But I want to know where the police are.
Guns are gone.
I sure hope.
The guns.
So what's kind of cool is they use the suits as ease. You'll see that, like.
Oh, there we go.
But they use the suits as the gi.
Sloppy double leg, if you ask me there now. Combat jitsu.
Konshu.
Here, if you ever fall down the stairs, like, it's not pretty.
But I'm dragging some movie like.
Oh, lovely double leg. Doesn't finish it because of the wall.
I can't let you get close to me.
Like, there's a lot of scrambling. Like, yeah. They're just
sprawling. Like.
Yeah, yeah.
One, no.
So there's a nice take down here, which is just watch it.
John takes some beating in these movies.
Oh, there he goes. There he goes.
That's
answer the phone. Come on.
Answer the phone, John.
Whose knife is that?
That's Collins.
Oh, the wiper. Galerid loved that. Yeah, Galerid loved that.
Lovely sweet.
Smash him, John. Smash into
this
him.
This is where the problem is. Look, he's doing spider guard. Lasso. Inverse turbo. Comes up on top.
He gets them out.
Yeah.
How many points would he be on here?
Lads,
I
think
another three for the stabbing.
Yeah.
I think Common must have gone to the same school as Glare did because he sweeped him and stabbed them. That's that real Brazilian jiu-jitsu.
Real inside joke.
Okay, it's game day. I'm having some biltong, beef jerky, chili flavor. It's very, very nice. There is, where is it? A lot of protein, but also a lot of salt. We got some chicken fried rice with salt and some Lucozade Sport with salt also. Fitz, yeah. It's game day. What have you had for breakfast?
So far I've had nothing, but it's early still.
Ready to go?
Born ready. What did you have for breakfast, Gerf?
I got it already. It's some chicken fried rice, some yerky,
and some cookies in the microwave.
Some cookies in the microwave.
He's lucky he can get to 110. Like,
well, I'm cutting down from 130 to 115.
He's looking very slim.
Thanks, babe.
Yeah.
Very slender profile on him.
Oh, what are these? Oh.
Oh, what are those?
Is this a commercial adult or adult product placement? Seek its strength. Wait, is that a zip on the inside?
Is that a zip on the inside so the pants don't tear?
What if I was wearing knee sleeves and I didn't want to take off my pants?
Mm.
I would just go. And then.
Yeah, I think all tracksuits have that.
And
no.
Then.
Yeah.
Not on the inside.
Not on the inside.
And then I would go slim again.
Yeah.
Oh, added durability due to the fact that the zip never opens the whole way and there's a slip of material on the inside.
3 months of training?
Show us that, Gerf.
Wait, what? Oh, this bit.
This bit?
This bit.
So the pants doesn't tear? Oh, wow.
This is only for exclusive members in your Facebook group because your normal audience.
You have nerds like that too.
It's pushed away. You don't have any respect for them. That's the rumor circling.
Who is this? This guy needs to stop.
I've got the inside.
And we're back in the room. And we're back in the room.
We're back in the room.
Okay.
All right.
I feel like this is the start of some sick trance song or like EDM. We used to call it dance back in the day.
Dance is different.
Dance is
like pop.
Such a boomer, really.
Is it not dance anymore?
No, it's a totally different genre.
It never was dance.
You know, me and the boys, we go to those raves, man. You just wouldn't get it.
You just wouldn't.
You just weren't there one time, so you're never gonna get it again.
So. I'm weighing in at 900 kg at the moment, but it's a serious problem between Gerf right now and Dara. They're having confidential discussions among themselves, and it's getting very intense. They've split from me, and they're gone off on their own. It looks like this could be the end of Seek a Strength.
So this is the post-fight review. So Fitz won his fight after you got his bye. Woo!
Silver medalist.
So you should
have got your medals for the video.
I'll go get it.
So Fitz basically was fighting a Kurdish gentleman. Very nice guy.
Very, very lovely.
Lovely guy.
He actually gave Dara a kiss on the forehead after Dara beat him.
We'll get to that. So
yeah.
I went for my fight first. Beat the first guy 13-0. Next guy came out. I crashed so heavy after the fight. Went up for a second guy.
Yeah.
He got me in a key lock. Dara came along. His fight. Jesus. And it was a good wrestle. It was a
very good fight.
Tough match.
There's a bit tough. Where I think we'll have a video hopefully where Fitz, I've never seen Fitz get up off the ground so fast. It was so war.
Even during training,
it was
like,
a war.
And we tell him to go hard, like
he doesn't.
Bounced off the ground.
Oh, like it was so
fast. It was like he fell and like stumbled up. He sprung up like a surfer.
No. Audible gasp
from
me when I was like, oh my god, I've never seen Fitz move that fast.
And I actually remember Kirk going, go on.
Yeah.
Yeah, under his breath, going, go on.
And then your man, Fitz is up 6-0. The guy got him in a bow and arrow choke of some sort. Fitz was trying to tuck his chin in.
Yeah,
there was
bow and arrow, 35 seconds to go.
Hopefully we have footage of the fight.
Yeah.
I think Galera has footage of the fight.
I think he does, yeah.
So there was 36 seconds to go, and then by the time he'd kind of gotten into position, we were all like, 25 seconds, don't tap Fitz.
Everyone was screaming.
So Fitz held out for 25 seconds. Getting half choked or nearly fully choked.
Yeah. Jeez, that was terrible.
Had the poker face on. Fitz came off the mat and was just literally like, I can't see. And was just, couldn't.
It wasn't that bad at first, I think.
No, I think it got worse.
He just seemed tired. He just seemed really tired. He was like, oh, fuck. I thought it was going to be the same as Gurf. Gurf bounced back quick. Like,
yeah.
But he got progressively where Gurf was, or Darryl
it got
was like,
very bad.
I can't cool down.
Mm-hmm.
And then you were on the floor for 10 minutes and we picked him up and he felt his back and it was like an iron. It was like, fucking ridiculous.
We put on one of those breaky ice things and it felt warm. It felt like it was just lukewarm touching you.
Yeah.
And I was like, oh dear. So then the medic kind of came over and was like, And in that meantime, Rambo just basically pulled Fitz out of the fight, which is fair. You couldn't have done anything. Fitz tried to stand
up. I think that was love. I went up to your man. He was like, where's Dara? And he pointed to you on the floor. In a heap, and I was like, that's him, and that's him from the fight.
We had him in
my coaching wristband.
You were like, no.
I had my coaching wristband, so I had the high ground. Like,
yeah, you were right.
Yeah.
Dara was like, no, don't pull me out of the fight, and Ram was like, it's too late.
Realistically, the fight could have been 45 minutes later, and I wouldn't have been ready.
No, God.
Like, because I then had to be brought outside.
Yeah. And you were still there, like, they moved on to the next division, and you were still there.
Yeah.
Like, so it was a long
time. No, I was in the reception of the leisure center having a breakdown. With no clothes on.
Fitz would have been due to fight the guy who beat me in the second round. Which would have been very interesting.
Yeah.
It was exactly as I thought it was going to be. It went exactly...
The main thing was...
Yeah.
Didn't lose the first fight.
No.
That would be horrible, going all the way to Bristol and losing your
first fight. That wasn't a dig at you. That wasn't.
No, I know.
Goals 1-5 were, don't lose my first round of the first jiu-jitsu competition.
Yeah.
That was number one goal. As soon as I did that, I was so happy. I was just like, out of my pan, exactly how I wanted. Takedowns, stay on top. Score points, go for a submission if I can get one, but no pressure.
Yeah.
And then it got to like the last minute and a half of mine, and I was up 13-0 or whatever. So he kept trying to stand up on me for some reason.
That was very strange.
So
Gurf's game plan was really strong takedown game, and Gurf's game plan came through phenomenally well. I was watching from like the little weigh-in cattle grid area, and just dragging people to the floor.
Dragging them. At one point, they looked up at Wilson and he was like, I was like,
yeah.
And then your man kept standing up. He actually, he kept trying to stand up at me. I think he was so fucked.
Yeah, so the rules in jiu-jitsu, like, if you get taken down, say if Gurf takes down his opponent, Gurf gets 2 points. If your man gets back up and Gurf takes him down again, he gets 2 points. But if your man had just stayed on the floor, Gurf wouldn't get more points from takedowns
because
you're not taking him down. So realistically, if I was his coach, I would just say, stay the fuck down.
I don't know why they weren't. They were like, use your weight, but we were standing
it was
up.
It was like sometimes in training, we just do takedowns and whoever gets most takedowns wins.
Yes.
That's kind of what you did, like.
Yeah.
There was very little jiu-jitsu on the floor, but the actual stand-up game was phenomenal.
Very good, yeah.
It got to like a minute and a half left, and I was just like, oh, I'm just going to pretend to wrestle him for a minute and a half, because there's no point.
Yeah.
I think you could have won on the ground if you hadn't rolled out, remember? You were at
yeah.
the point you were on the ground, like, and...
That's one thing I don't
like. They reset the position standing.
Yeah.
Which, you could, I think you were in, like, bottom half or something like that, or top
yeah.
half.
I full mount twice, I think.
Yeah.
I don't
yeah,
like...
Yeah, you did. You got the takedown, got a pass, and full mount, and got,
yeah.
got the 7 points.
That was,
It was great to watch.
Yeah.
I don't like, in competition, the resetting. I like in training, you just keep going until... Whatever, like, you know, or someone will drag you back in.
Yeah, it's understandable, but you have
no,
to.
No, no, I totally get that.
But yeah, I was in the full mount and got reset. And they got like, get your grip back. The referees were phenomenal.
The referee was so nice.
So, so good. And, like, really diligent with, like, left hand, right shoulder, right hand. And, like, literally counting out all the different grips.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And then get them back perfect.
Yeah.
But it is, like, it's killer. I was in full mount, got moved back to the middle. Got the grips all set up, all the grips are right, and then come back to you.
But it's never the same.
No.
It's never the same.
And I got
never.
Bumped off like
that.
2 seconds later, you know?
Yeah, it's, sometimes you get stopped in the middle of like shrimping or getting out or something.
Yeah, yeah.
And you go back and it's like, it's not the same thing, you know?
No.
Like
my ref was kind of nice to me actually, after I got tapped.
He said something to you actually.
He talked to me, he was like, I just want to see you get up. And so a lot of people, they get up after they get tapped out and go, just fuck this, like, and then
yeah.
just get into the mess. So he was like, just take it easy. He's like, thanks, man.
Yeah.
That's
like,
naturally, you know?
No,
the whole competition was very well run.
It was. Very
really,
good.
Really good.
Yeah.
When we were, after the first time, we were returning, you know, or we'd face the judges first, and then they raised their hand or whatever, and then I just kind of didn't know what he was doing, and he was like, turn. Out of the corner of his mouth, he was like, turn again.
Yeah.
They were just really mostly students of Pedro.
I think
yeah. There were some good looking referees that just looked like solid fighters. Like
they all looked like fighters.
The guy with the big beard that was refereeing your matches or some of your matches, like on your mat.
He
looked fucking dangerous. Like
there's a lot of people watching.
Yeah, so I think there's 530 something competitors.
Yeah, that's what they said. Yeah.
And then if you take
family members,
there's probably sharing of coaches, so you probably take another third of that on.
It was a lot busier for the kids' matches than our matches.
I
suppose a lot of kids.
Two parents or
two
like parents and yeah.
brothers, sisters.
Yeah.
Kind of like.
No, very, very good. Good crack. It had the smell of an Irish like county badminton match.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, where it's a Sunday, you're going to be there for 8 hours.
Yeah, yeah.
Everybody's there. There's children running around the place.
Oh yeah.
Nobody knows when the next match is.
Chaos when we walked in.
Chaos.
When we walked in,
people set up these post-apocalyptic camps where all the gear bags are.
There
and
were
there's
people sleeping as well, like, you know?
Yeah, two or three people
yeah.
with those bags at all times.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Never doing ultra-heavy ever again.
Never, ever again.
I don't know if like your fan base doesn't care, but I did lose my fight.
But I didn't want to talk about it.
I know I didn't want to talk about it.
That's kind of awkward, because I said at least you didn't lose the first fight.
Ramble.
I did go against... Basically, the Slender Man of Jiu-Jitsu.
He was sick.
11 feet tall?
He was so good at Jiu-Jitsu.
So, blue belt, 88 kilos, around...
12 feet.
18 and a half feet tall, I'd say. And his arms were even longer
than
that.
And if we're going to give the actual height,
yeah.
minimum 7 foot. Like, minimum 7 foot.
No, on a serious note, minimum 7 feet.
Like...
Rambo's average height, but he was like a hobbit.
So usually when you're doing grips, I'm doing grip like here against somebody my size. My grip was up, like my...
Yeah.
It was above your head, like...
But...
I was...
You
all stretched out.
Rambo still took him down. Your judo was great, standing judo was great, but if you'd gone again, I think you would have gotten this.
Yeah.
But he went on to win the division, which is always a...
If you're going to lose, you want to lose to the person.
Yeah, the guy that lost beat everyone at blue belt level.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And
so I'm happy with
him. No, he won the absolute, didn't he?
Everybody would have
won. And he didn't even win by points. He won every match by submission.
Because he's a slender man. He was 18 foot tall, like...
I watched him against the guy in the division final, and he got a triangle from like the most obscure angle I've ever seen. It was so.
But he's 18 foot tall. Of course he can. Like,
obscure angle triangle.
Yeah.
But never doing ultra heavy again.
Ultra heavy is simply too heavy. They're so big.
I think your man must have been 115 kilos. The fella last two.
What it reminded me of is like the first time you play adult level rugby. And you're still a teenager, you're still a child.
Junior B football.
Yeah, and you, like, as you're running out onto the pitch or as you're, like, walking down the corridor in the change rooms, you'll pass, like, a front row forward and you're fucked.
Yes.
I'd say a lot of them had dad strength.
They had all the strength.
Dad strength.
For me, it wasn't their strength. It was just their weight. You know, if they're coming down on top of you, you're like, oh my god, there's 225 odd kilos of a person here.
Yeah.
Like, and you're just.
So in your.
And usually, you love lads coming on top of you.
You can't put that.
In your second fight,
yeah,
what I was like, Jesus, these are like, this character is insane.
Yeah.
Was like, you were on the back foot.
Yeah, yeah.
When he was pushing against you, I was like, Gurf's the strongest man I know.
Yeah, yeah.
And he's walking backwards.
Well, like, second strongest man you know.
Yeah, I'm number one.
But never, the reason I had to do Ultra Heavies was because, oh, there was no one else, and you could have made it as well.
That was the thing. We could have just, knowing what we know now, we could have just had the Seek off.
Yeah, yeah. Which would have been no crap.
No.
The final would have been great.
Seek also, off. We have a Seek off 3 to 4 times a week in the gym.
Yeah.
So.
So if we, there was nobody, for some reason, there was just nobody in the 100 kilo, 100.5.
Which was weird.
White belt, yeah.
Because in blue belt, there was a fuck ton. There are a lot of white belts there. A lot of white belts.
I see why you can't move up if you don't make weight. I make sense now having
seen No, having seen the run out of the day, there's no way where you could simply, like, in weightlifting, it's so different where you just get bumped into the next fight.
Mm-hmm.
You know?
Yeah.
Whereas the way those competitions are run, so Gurf's talking about is if you show up on the mat, like you weigh in 10, 15 minutes before realistically.
Yeah.
All the fights today were.
Wait. So for anyone who doesn't jiu-jitsu, your gi is included in your weight. That's so fucking
so everything so you wear on the mat, so you go fully dressed, you walk up, you weigh in, and then that cattle grid place I was talking about, you basically just wait in a little square, and then you go out onto the competition floor. In most sports, it's like a couple hours before, you'll weigh in, if you don't make weight and you need to lose 500 grams, you'll go and go to the bathroom or do whatever. That doesn't happen here.
No. So,
I had a horrible day when it came to that weight thing.
Yeah,
that was stressing you out.
I actually weighed in 2 kg lighter with the gi on. Like,
yeah,
I was 86 going into the fight. Like,
see, you had the lighter gi as well.
That was handy.
Lala medals coming back. Two back door. To be fair,
second, third.
Yeah,
2 first place medals. Another first. No,
the two lads.
It's 4.
4 first place. Yeah. 4 gold.
Yeah, testament to Galera.
Yeah, so everyone except the losers in this room got gold. Maybe we should have stayed in the other hotel, that could have been the difference.
That was the difference, I'd say.
Yeah.
Oh, we are the losers.
Also, Testa cutting weight, it was phenomenal.
Fucking unbelievable.
Yeah, one of our good friends, you would have seen him in the Power Clean video, he was in the gym with us in Italy.
He won his division.
Derision.
He rang the ring.
Yeah.
He won his division sign. Sorry, I hate to split people up.
You know,
I hate.
What did you say?
You keep asking why you're not on the podcast.
What did you say?
This is why.
I didn't hear what you said.
You hate the division sign. What? And then he said, like, divide by. And then he said, I keep hate. We're running out of room on the tape.
Any last words?
Out of 10, your first jiu-jitsu competition?
10 out of 10.
Yeah, exactly as I imagined.
Yeah, minus 9 from Rambo, but...